Hi there, my name is Alex, nonprofit cyber resilience specialist here at the CyberPeace Institute, and today I have the pleasure to welcome you to Module 1 of our AI Skills for Nonprofits training series. In this first session, we'll demystify artificial intelligence. We are going to start by breaking down what AI is, look at its evolution, understand its core foundational concepts, and then explore how nonprofits use it in their daily work. But before going any further in the topic, let's start by watching this short video together to better understand what exactly is AI.
What exactly is artificial intelligence? We speak of AI when computer systems perform tasks that usually require human intelligence. This includes, for example, recognizing images, making decisions, or engaging in dialogue. To do this, the AI systems must be equipped with knowledge and experience. This can be achieved in two ways. You can program each individual instruction so that the machines solve the tasks step by step. This is comparable to a cooking recipe or assembly instructions. Alternatively, you can use programs that learn from data themselves. This enables them to detect relevant information, draw conclusions, or make predictions. This is known as machine learning. We all have probably dealt with AI at some point in our lives. When we watch films, listen to music, or shop online, AI gives us recommendations about what we might like. AI is capable of converting spoken language into text and translating it into other languages. AI is a central component of robotics. Robots make our everyday lives easier or take on strenuous activities. Self-driving vehicles recognize their environment through AI and can react to it. AI is becoming increasingly important within medicine. It supports doctors when diagnosing diseases. Also, more and more patients use AI-based apps for initial diagnosis. In the educational sector, AI helps to individualize learning activities, for example, on digital learning platforms. AI is becoming increasingly important. Once we understand how AI works, we can better gauge where it can support everyday activities at home and at work, and where we would rather make our own decisions. AI will not replace humans, but it is getting better and better at supporting us. For this, we need an AI competent society.
Let's start with the basics now. AI, or artificial intelligence, is defined as a machine-based system that can make predictions, recommendations, or decisions based on human-defined goals. These systems can work with varying degrees of autonomy, meaning that they can sometimes act independently of human input. You might ask yourself, is AI a product of the 21st century alone? Well, no. Looking closer at the existing research on the topic, AI emerged in the middle of the 20th century. For example, back in 1956, John McCarthy has introduced the term artificial intelligence for the first time. Only 8 years later, ELISA, the first natural language processing program, is then introduced to the world. The years to follow, though, were not the easiest for AI as a field. This is what is referred to as the AI winter, where progress started to stagnate due to limited resources and funding cuts. Nonetheless, AI researchers and scientists did not give up, and at the beginning of the 21st century, a new wave of AI innovation started to take place. All the way up to 2022, when ChatGPT was introduced and took the world by storm. Going forward, it is important to demystify some foundational concepts of AI. Now, we can look at AI, artificial intelligence, as the broadest concept. We can look at it as a field of study that has the goal of creating machines that replicate human intelligence. In this case, machine learning is then a subset of AI focused on learning from data, be it via supervised, unsupervised, and reinforcement learning. Think of it more like labeling the data to make decisions, like teaching a child with flashcards. Then we have deep learning, Deep learning is a further subset using neural networks to achieve even more complex tasks. Deep learning uses these neural networks to analyze unlabeled data. And this is perfect for actually recognizing images, understanding speech, generating audio and video. And it has a broader application, especially nowadays. Furthermore, an AI system includes everything: the model, data, the user interface. And then an AI model is like the brain. It recognizes patterns and it starts to interpret them. And finally, an AI agent then takes action based on its environment. It can make decisions and interact with users or other systems. Large language models, or LLMs, like Copilot or ChatGPT, for example, are trained on huge amounts of text to generate human-like language. Neural networks, just as we've seen a few slides before, they are actually structured around the way the human brain actually functions. It also implies a set of interconnected nodes that are actually organized into layers, building upon deep learning algorithms. And finally, expert systems use rules to make decisions, just like a human expert would actually. On the screen, you now have the main technologies behind AI, as well as the most important milestones in terms of its historical development. But I would like to share with you a quick fact. Did you know that it took ChatGPT 2 months to reach 100 million users? It took the mobile phone around 16 years to reach the same number, and the internet 6 years. That's quite impressive. And it all comes down to this new technology that we all appreciate and that helps us increase our efficiency, known as generative AI. Generative AI goes beyond simple analysis. It starts to create. It can create text, images, music. It's trained to produce original content from patterns that it has learned previously. And with deep learning technologies, this is actually possible. Now, we can differentiate between traditional AI and generative AI. While traditional AI is focused on analyzing and recognizing patterns, generative AI is actually trying to simulate human-like creativity. Generative AI can create a wide variety of content, just like I've mentioned before, from images to text to audio and video content. This is also known as a multimodal generative AI model. Let's have a quick look at this short video on generative AI to learn more.
This is generative AI, the innovative tool that's making AI a household name. Say goodbye to the blank page. With generative AI, you have a superpowered partner that's able to create original content on command. Images, text, music, even code. But where does all this power come from? Large language models train on huge libraries of data. No, not quite. Now that's a data set. So when you write a prompt, AI is able to identify different patterns and understand you. The more detailed your prompt, the more accurate your output will be. With generative AI, you have a companion to achieve anything. All you have to do is ask.
Now, how cool is that? AI is nowadays used all around the world in terms of predicting the weather, for example, or generating images for marketing purposes. Or maybe, you know, us getting shopping suggestions or using AI ourselves to conduct textual analysis. It starts to permeate all aspects of society. For example, in national security, it does help with intelligence analysis. And this can actually help decision makers make better and faster decisions to counter national security threats. In healthcare, just like we've seen in the first video, AI is being used by doctors to provide better diagnoses and treatments to their patients. And AI is also being used in nonprofit organizations. In nonprofits, AI is used to enhance operational efficiency, to improve data analysis, to engage with donors in terms of reporting or grant proposals even, and to address some of the most complex social issues of our time. But let's have a closer look at the most common use cases of AI in nonprofits. AI can be used to edit and proofread research, to summarize very long reports and texts more generally, and to extract the most important key points. It can also be used for translation, which can actually help some nonprofit staff overcome language barriers. It is also very useful in project management and also in fundraising, as mentioned previously. Now, it is clear that AI can do a lot of things, and AI can help nonprofits write better grant proposals. It can analyze past wins, identify key data points, and even optimize the structure and language of the actual application. Besides the time saving and increased efficiency that AI brings, this tool can also help other colleagues overcome certain barriers and perform better. Furthermore, chatbots, they do offer 24/7 support to beneficiaries of nonprofits, from answering frequently asked questions to guiding them in case of a crisis. Using a chatbot can actually scale the reach of a nonprofit by maintaining the same level of quality engagement. I mean, for example, a nonprofit in Colombia active in the mental health sector has created its own chatbot to empower their beneficiaries to seek support whenever needed. And AI can do so much more. For example, increase the quality and level of marketing and social media content generation for a nonprofit, automating tasks to save time and use that time for other more important commitments, also doing data analysis and help nonprofits with their coding slash programming needs. There is literally an AI for everything. And this website does actually exist. It is called There's an AI for That, and it can help you identify the right AI tool for the task that you need to complete. Be it drafting a grant proposal, creating promotional content, or helping you automate certain tasks. There's an AI for That is a great resource to keep handy. At the same time, there is also this massive platform, community-driven platform, where different people and organizations, they share AI models, many of them open source and free, that other organizations, such as nonprofits that run on limited budgets, can adopt, train, and use in their own context. Going forward, you have to keep in mind that you're not alone and your learning journey is not stopping here. Please do explore some of the sources that you see now on the screen by scanning the QR code, and I highly encourage you to check out the comprehensive AI nonprofit skills collection from Microsoft. Thank you very much for your attention, and I look forward to seeing you in the second session.